Hey everyone, it's Cassie. Welcome back for another Pearblossom Press video. We're going to be making an all-occasion card, so let's talk about what we're using. We're going to be using the One Light. You guys know I love these, and we're going to bring in the Pearblossom Press stamp set because that's just a must. The other stamp set that we're bringing in is from Catherine Pooler Designs. This one's called Hey There Dumpling, and I do have the matching dies to go along with it. It's so cute. You can add little faces to all your little things. We're going to be using the Today Word Die from Catherine Pooler, and we're also using the Today Sentiments. I've got some colored vellum from Pearblossom Press. This is translucent colors, and there's 45 sheets in here. They measure the full size of an A2 size card, so gotta have those. I'm also going to be using some black sentiment stock. This stuff is my absolute favorite for sentiments. And then I have a couple of random dies in here from Trinity Stamps. We've got our Dainty Scallop Rectangle and then our Clean Cut Layers A2 Set A. And so we're going to just jump right into it. So I've pulled out some of the vellum, and there's a bunch of different colors in that pack. So if you like vellum, I highly suggest getting it because there's so many colors in there. I chose more of a yellowy type color. And I'm stamping the faces, and I realize I don't want the faces onto these white pieces of cardstock. I do want it on the vellum. The thing with vellum that you have to understand, and we'll talk about why we're all doing all of this as we go along, but the thing with vellum that you have to understand is that the ink isn't going to absorb into it. So I'm using a pigment ink, and it is sitting right on top of that vellum. And I'm stamping out the faces. I wasn't sure exactly how many of these little dumplings I was gonna want. So I did stamp out 5 of them. We're gonna stamp some little cheeks on there. And I'm gonna stamp those cheeks using a dye-based ink. And again, not gonna absorb into the vellum. We're gonna use some Prom Queen from Simon Hurley Create. It's gonna make those cheeks nice and pink. And we'll stamp them on all of those. Now, if I just rubbed my finger across here, those would wipe away completely. So you could just use some clear embossing powder if you wanted on that. It would absorb the embossing powder and then that would stay put. I decide to take the little dumpling. I'm gonna heat set that a little bit. It doesn't make a ton of difference. I'm gonna heat set it though, because I want those faces to stay fairly, you know, like stay put mostly, but I could still wipe these away. So again, if you want it to be permanent, you'd need to use some clear embossing powder. So I've pulled out my embossing powder. I am going to use a anti-static powder tool over the top of that, just kind of pouncing it because I don't want that powder to stick to different places. And I'm going to bring in some clear embossing ink because I want to stamp the dumpling over the top. It will pick up the cheeks a little bit, so I decide to start cleaning off that stamp in between, because as you can see, I did transfer a little bit of that to my ink pad, but that's not a big deal. It's not going to hurt my ink pad. So cleaning off in between, stamping the dumpling down over the top of those little faces, and now I will cover those with that clear embossing powder. And so it looks kind of white right now, but once I heat that, it's going to be translucent. All right, and then one of the little dumplings didn't get fully stamped, I guess, but it's not gonna affect in the end. So we'll heat set that, and it will melt quickly, so move your heat gun around. You don't wanna burn your vellum. And then you'll see these shiny little dumplings on there. That's going to be helpful for when we die cut. But check it out. Isn't that cute? We got these little shiny dumplings that look like they just came out of the fryer. I do want to use the or make these into stickers, but there is one that I don't want to make into a sticker. He's going to be the one that we actually have our light come through. The rest of these are not. So I've put that through my little sticker maker machine. And then I'm going to trim those down, and we're going to put those onto some white cardstock. Now you might be thinking, why did we go through all of that? The reason I'm choosing to make it a sticker is because if you put any sort of adhesive behind vellum, it usually shows through. So if you turn it into a sticker, then it's all adhesive, so you can't see it. So I'm just sticking that onto some white cardstock. I'll put 4 of those on there. Again, we're leaving one of them off to the side. We'll use him later. So we'll trim these down, and then I'm going to run this through my die cutting machine with that matching dumpling die. And it's easy to line that up because, you know, we did some clear embossing over the top of them, so it's actually pretty simple. And I'll show you what that looks like afterwards, but these little dumplings are so darn cute, and I just love the shine that they end up having to them. And I used the vellum because I wanted cohesion amongst all of those dumplings, because that other one, like I said, is going to be used for where the light shines through. But isn't he adorable? He just makes me so happy. Just a cute little dumpling. So I've got 4 of those, and then our other one. I'm going to go ahead and stamp out all of my sentiments while I'm thinking about it. So we've got the Hey There Dumpling, You're All That and Dim Sum. And then we're going to use Is All About You. So we're going to put all those onto some of this black sentiment stock. And I've said this several times. I love this sentiment stock because it is so smooth that if you want to emboss over the top, you typically don't have to worry about your powder sticking to places that you don't want it to stick to as long as you use an anti-static powder tool. So I've stamped that down. We're going to cover all that with the white embossing powder, and then we'll heat set that till that is smooth and melted, and then we can rub away the residue from the anti-static powder tool once we're done. So I did that. Now we're going to trim all these down so that we have our three sentiments all separated. And once those are all done, Miles is going to come in and check things out. Briefly. I did go ahead and die cut out the word today 3 times out of white cardstock. I just wanted to make it look a little bit more like a chipboard piece, so that's why I did that. And this one's a little easier to do because it's the letters are a little bit thicker. And so I'll just use a little bit of liquid glue, and then we'll start stacking those up. I do end up bringing in another color of the word today, simply because the pattern paper that I choose, this doesn't stand out too much on it, so I do have to make some provisions there, and we'll talk about that when we get to it. But yeah, we'll stack that last one up, and then we can set this off to the side. And then we'll talk about actual assembly of our card. All right, so I'm going to use this pattern paper called I Love You Soy, and it's 6x6 from Catherine Pooler. Goes perfectly with this stamp set, and as you can see, I already stamped or die cut out all of my pieces. And so I do want to die cut the centers out of these. And the reason for that is that way I don't have to die cut the little dumpling through all of my pieces, because we need that light to come through the whole, all the layers. And so I figured it would just be easier. And then I could even save some of that cardstock by doing it this way. So I've pulled out some of those rectangle dies and we're cutting out the centers. Just make sure that you pick one that isn't going to be bigger than your the die that you're, or the rectangle that you're putting on top of it. So I'll put my liquid glue down. We'll stick this blue rectangle down on top. You'll see we still have a good center bit through there, and then this piece is ready to go. And then I can start thinking about how I'm going to assemble all of my pieces on front of my patterned paper. And so you can see here that the word today doesn't really pop on there. So this is where I bring in that blue cardstock and die cut it out of that. And then I'm going to put it down on top of the white, but I'm going to off center it a little bit to make it look like it's standing out even more 3D. So it's got a bit of a shadow behind it. And I think that looks a lot better. We're going to make it stand out even more later on when I put some glossy accents over the word. But now I need to decide where I want this little dumpling to be. And so I've got my die out, and now I'm going to pull out my mechanism, my one light. So I've got the battery and the one light, pop that battery into place, and then the light shines through, and it's awesome. But I just want to make sure before I die cut the dumpling out of my piece of patterned paper that I am positioning it correctly. I don't want my one light to be sticking out of the bottom, you know, behind the scallops. So I'm moving that little dumpling die up, and then I'm going to hold it in place with some mint tape, run that through my die cutting machine, and that was the perfect placement for where we're going to put our dumpling. So now I'll bring in that one dumpling that I cut aside, and so now we need another piece of vellum just to make sure that it's a little bit thicker and you can't see the mechanism through it. I'll flip it over, put some glue down, and then we'll line up our little dumpling through the hole. He looks so cute. And then I am going to put that other piece right on top of the piece we just put. So that'll just give it a double thickness, and then you can't see the mechanism through it, which is perfect. That's what we want. And then we test it out. Everything seems to be good. I like where that's going to go, and the light shines really well. So now we can attach this down to the panel that we've already started. Just putting a little bit of liquid glue behind there, and now you understand why I cut the rectangles out of the center of those two pieces. So this is going to be a fairly thick card anyway once we put our foam tape on it, and we don't want extra bulk either. So now we can start positioning our sentiments where those are going to go. And we'll worry about the dumplings afterwards, the extra dumplings. So I'll adhere my sentiment down to the top. Hey there, dumpling. And I'm not going to attach the today just yet. I'm going to attach the is all about you underneath the word today, because I want that to overlap just a little bit, the word today to overlap just a little bit on top of there. And so now we can attach the word today. It's coming along. I love how this looks. And it's so fun. It's different and it's so fun. And I love that this can be an all occasion card. So now my little quality control is going to come in there and step on everything, sit on all the things, walk away with things. Miles will not be ignored for sure. All right. So playing around with that a little bit, I now need to attach my mechanism down. So I'm just grabbing a couple pieces of some double-sided adhesive that we've put onto our one light. I'll peel off that release paper, kind of playing around with where that goes, but I'll peel off that release paper and then I'm just going to lightly place it down because I don't want it to adhere just yet, because again, I want to make sure I'm attaching that down where it needs to go. So it's just setting on there. Okay, I know I'm going to need to move it over just a tiny bit, and now I'm going to adhere that down. That's exactly where I want it to be. Perfect. All right, so now we need to bring in some of that world's best foam tape. Y'all have been watching these videos, so you know that I am absolutely obsessed with this foam tape. It's amazing. It really is the world's best. You'll see here that I am cutting through that foam tape, and normally when you cut through foam tape with your scissors, it sticks all over your scissors and it even gunks them up, but not with this stuff. This stuff's amazing. It doesn't do that. It's also repositionable for the first 30 minutes, which is great. And the release paper comes off super easy as well. All right, so we're just gonna put that all around the mechanism. We also just wanna make sure that that tape isn't going to show through where we have our dumpling. So I check that from time to time. And then now I can peel off all of that release paper. Again, super simply. And then once all that is peeled off, we can attach down our panel to our card base. Love it. And then we can attach down a couple of those little dumplings. And we're going to put two of them on there. And if I had been thinking ahead of time, I would have brought in that Pearblossom Press stamp set while I was already doing my embossing, but I thought about it now. So I've brought in the press here, stamped that onto some of that black sentiment stock, and then we're, you know, heat embossing that as well. I'm just going to trim that down real small, and then we'll attach that down with some liquid glue to where it goes, so the recipient knows exactly where to press. And then I'm going to stamp or put the rest of my stuff on the inside, your all that and dim sum. And then our last two little dumplings will go on the inside of the card. And then I am going to stamp our light bulb on the back because you just have to. It's a light up card. So we'll put that on the back. And then that's actually going to finish off our card for today. So you end up with this card now that could be used for just about any occasion. Anytime you'd want to celebrate somebody, who wouldn't want to receive a little dumpling card like this? I love it. I hope you do. If you do, please hit that like button. Definitely consider subscribing if you haven't already done so. And be sure to check out all that Pearblossom Press has going on over on their blog, Facebook page, and Instagram for more crafty inspiration. Thanks for stopping by, and we'll see you soon.